your BFID, finance.
What that is?
Very interesting. Then he told me, I thought I want to have a one-to-one meeting. The embassy told me it is not possible. Then I said, okay. Then he sent a word to me, I want to have one-to-one meeting. Then I asked him, I never invited you, how you are able to come here, or any inspiration, any this one. Then he told me, I have seen so many articles on Wall Street magazine, so many New York Times like that. Then I thought I want to visit this place. That is how he came. Whatever I want to inform all of you, world is very small village, global village. If you do something good, naturally it will be attracted. During this tenure, I have seen
very, very powerful communicator and also excellent performer. All over the world, people used to watch him, what he is doing, what is the next move like that. Great leader of the global community.
I am very happy today, Tony Blair Initiative for Global Change is working. Always, if you reach one stage, you will think how to leave good legacy. That is what exactly is doing. I really appreciate all his efforts. Recently we met in Singapore. I had a very good interaction. I interviewed him at that time. Our minister, Information Technology, met him in Dubai. After that, this man is responsible for Hussein. He is responsible of getting respected Tony Blair here. We won't disappoint you, sir. We'll give you something, we'll learn something from you. I will be very happy for that. But I want to introduce the subject first. Sir, you know you visited Hyderabad. I was responsible for creating one of the best knowledge city in Hyderabad. I had a vision. At that time I thought, we want to go for knowledge economy. For knowledge economy, at that time information technology was the very, very exact idea of knowledge economy.
Okay.
Then I started so many brainstorming sessions. Then I constructed first building, high-tech city. Then I went up to America to attract all IT companies. Then I met with very great difficulty Bill Gates, and finally became good friend of mine. First time outside Seattle, he started his office in Hyderabad. That is how we turned Hyderabad into a knowledge economy. If you see beauty of Hyderabad today, one of the best ecosystem, nowhere in the country, 165 kilometers outer ring road with the 8 lanes I conceived at that time, 4+ floor, the service roads. And also Greenfield Airport we conceived at that time, one of the best Greenfield Airport, first of its kind in India. And also Cyberabad City, it is totally knowledge economy. I brought all companies all over the world. Now things are happening in Hyderabad. But in politics, you and me are aware, sometimes some unknown things also will come. That is how 2004, state is bifurcated, 2014, into two states. I hailed from this place. So I came here now, as Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. Name is same. But Telangana was able to separate from Andhra Pradesh state with capital Hyderabad. Sir, after coming here, we had so many disadvantages. We don't have office, no capital, no buildings, no industry, known industry, and also we don't have education institutions, all these things. So we started fresh. Then we prepared vision document by taking clue. We are having nearly 1,000 kilometers sea coast. That is the starting point. And also we are very strong in knowledge economy. So both things, how to make it, I started working. This is where, sir, I have given vision document first time. Again, long at that time for Hyderabad, combined on the base, I have given Vision 2020. We started in 1995-96. Now I have given Vision 2050, three phases. 2022, we wanted to be one among top three in the country. 2029, we wanted to be best destination India with happiness as an index. And 2050, global destination, preferred destination. That is how we are measuring. You name anything, everything we are working now. Global benchmarking, everything. So for this, as on today in government, everything, if you can go through, it is only standalone systems. Silo approach. So I want to bridge all these things. Because of that, seven missions, we are bringing all departments together, like-minded, either primary sector, agriculture and water resources, even urbanization, even human resources, service sector, industry, like that. To have such this type of grid approach, five grids, one is power, gas, road, water, fiber. So I wanted to have focus on grids. If we see, sir, now on power, we are able to connect every home. On gas, we are able to give gas for every home. Now I am going piped gas, every home, PNG, that also we are working, that we are working in a big way. Road grid, either in a village, cement road, connecting to main road, depending on traffic, single lane, double lane, four lane, or six lane or eight lane we are constructing. And also on water, I want to give quality water every home. Within 1.5-2 years time, I can give every home with measurable quality from control room or from central, from RTG. Fiber grids are, this is one of the most interesting time. To have fiber grid every home, it is costing around $1 billion. So it is very costly. So I decided existing electrical poles I used, I have run one wire. It is costing me only 300 crores or 350 crores, 1/10 of that money. Now it is serving my purpose to start with. And also with Government of India, everything we are working. Every home I am connecting 15 Mbps by giving all channels, 200 channels. And also all content, you name any content I can give, at the rate of 149 rupees per month. It is very cheap. Nowhere in the world $2 if you pay, 3 telephones, 15 Mbps I can connect. This is the biggest exercise we are doing. And sir, here if you see, one is AP Fiber, I told you. E-Pragati, one project we are conceiving. My advisor, Mr. Satyanarayana, is working on that. Everything will be real-time, government to government, government to citizen. Everything we are integrating now. We are working on that. We are using here, one is, very interestingly, Aadhaar. Aadhaar is a authentication with fingerprint or iris or facial, so many ways we are getting. That is purely, even Supreme Court has held, some of the areas we can use it. Now in Andhra Pradesh we are using so many areas on authentication. Now we are going for Budhar. That is another every land parcel. I want to have a geo-reference. And also with geo-reference, I will mark everything. We will give unique number just like Aadhaar. For human being, Aadhaar is a unique number. For land parcel, we are giving Budhar as a unique number. For a human being, biometric is the reference, authentication. For land, geo reference is the authentication. Anybody want to transfer land, geo reference plus biometric. It is a foolproof system. Nobody can tamper. That is the system we are reaching. Mm-hmm. And also we are going so many ways how to integrate departments, everything we are working.